Good morning, students. The first chapter of class 6 English grammar is parts of speech. So let us begin learning them. Firstly, we need to know what are parts of speech and how many parts of speech are there in English grammar. The answer is there are 8 word classes or parts of speech in English grammar. They are noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. Note, the point to be noted is modern grammar also includes another word class called determiners. Basically, we learn 8 parts of speech, but in modern grammar, we are also including determiners these days. Now, let us learn the definition of parts of speech. The part of speech indicates how the word functions in meaning as well as grammatically within the sentence. For understanding the parts of speech, it is essential to determine the correct definition of the word when using the dictionary. You might have noticed that whenever you look or search for a word in a dictionary, there are lots of meaning of the similar word or the same word, and you are confused to know that which meaning will be suitable to the given or the requisite word. So for that, you need to know the part of speech, that how the word functions in meaning in a sentence or in a grammar. By learning the parts of speech, you can place the right word in the requisite directions and in a requisite sentence. Let us have a deep look on all the 8 parts of speech. We will begin with number 1, noun. You very well know what a noun is. Noun is a naming word. Definition of noun. A noun is a word which means or which refers to a person, place, animal or things. For example, Pratap, horse, Nepal, etc. Other example, John lives in Mumbai. Here, John is a noun and Mumbai is a noun. John is a name of a person and Mumbai is a name of a place. Number 2, pronoun. A pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. Pronoun is commonly used to avoid repetition of noun. Use pronoun in a sentence just to avoid the repetition of noun. Repeating the noun does not make the sentence or the paragraph look good. So, we avoid the use of noun and in that place we use a pronoun. The most common pronouns are I, me, you, we, us, he, him, they, them, etc. Example of a pronoun, Ram is a good boy. Full stop. Ram is loved by all. Now, replacing the second noun, the Ram used twice in a sentence. Now, replace the second one with a pronoun. Ram is a good boy. Instead of Ram, now we are going to use he. He is loved by others. So, this is how you can avoid the repetition of noun by using the pronoun. Third one, verb. A verb says what somebody or something does. Verbs are also called doing words or action words. You know, since you have been learning grammar since class first, that verbs are the doing words or the action words. Whatever is done in a sentence, whatever is done to the subject and to the object is considered as verb. A few verb like is, am, are, was, were, basically which belongs to be family in grammar, express a state or condition. Examples of verb are Ria is writing an essay, where writing is main verb and is acts as helping verb. What are main verb and helping verb? We will continue this in detail in the chapter verb, that is the upcoming chapter, next chapter. Second, father goes for jogging every morning, where jogging is the main verb and goes is helping or auxiliary verb. Number 4, adjective. An adjective is a word which describes or says more about a noun or a pronoun. For example, good, a good boy, tall, a tall building. We can simply say a boy, but we are using good to define what kind of boy. Same way, we can simply say a building, but we are adding tall to identify what kind of building. So adjective is a word which describes a noun or pronoun in some much better and efficient way, basically in terms of quality and quantity. Example of adjective, Akbar was a king. A simple sentence where Akbar is a noun and king is also a noun. Now adding adjective brave to the sentence. The sentence become now Akbar was a brave king. In the first sentence we stated that Akbar, which is a noun, is a king. Adding adjective brave, we came to know that what kind of king Akbar was. Hello students, in the last video we described the four parts of a speech: noun, pronoun, verb and adjective. Now we will continue with the other four. They are adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. Let's begin with adverb, the fifth part of a speech. An adverb is a word that mainly adds to the meaning of a verb and say how, where and when an action is done. We define verb as action word, that what is being done in a sentence to the subject is defined as verb. Now the adverb adds more to the meaning of verb by telling how, where and when. That is, examples of adverb are Virat batted well. Number 2, Raman please sit here. Number 3, Diya do this work now. In the first sentence, batted is verb and well is adverb. How? Because it is telling us the answer that how Virat batted in a very well manner. Number 2, Raman please sit here. This is an example which tells or add to the meaning where. It tells us that where Raman has to sit, Raman has to sit here. Where sit is verb and here is adverb. Similarly, in the third sentence, work is verb and the when the work is to be done, it gives the answer of when, that is now. Now is adverb. Moving to the sixth part of speech, preposition. A preposition is a word like at, in, with, for, from, to, into, etc., used before a noun or a pronoun to show place, time, method, reason, etc. As an adjective is used to add more to the meaning of noun and pronoun, similarly, adding prepositions to noun and pronouns, we come to know the time, the place, the method, the reason some work is being done to the noun or pronoun. Examples, number 1, the museum is open from 9:30 to 6, Tuesday to Sunday. Preposition from, it's the preposition of time. Number 2, the cat is under the chair. Preposition under, it is the preposition of place. It tells us that where the cat is sitting, it is sitting under the chair. Number 3, he will die by the sword. This is preposition of method, where preposition is by. It tells us the method or manner that how he will be killed. He will be dying because of the sword. Number 4, we use coal in hydraulic plants to make electricity. This is the preposition of reason or cause, that how the electricity is being made with the help of coal, where preposition is to. Seventh part of speech, conjunction. Just like a word junction joins two platforms, you may be familiar with the word railway junction, where two platforms meet together. In the same way, conjunction in English grammar means to join two words, two phrases or two sentences. Some of the common joining words or conjunctions are and, but, or, so, because, though, if, etc. Examples, number 1, I don't like tea, full stop. I don't like coffee. Adding conjunction, I don't like either tea or coffee. You can make your sentence short and more meaningful using the conjunction. Number 2, he was ill, full stop. He was cheerful. Adding conjunction, he was ill but cheerful. Number 3, I got up late I missed the first bus. Adding conjunction, I got up late, so I missed the first bus. And the last conjunction, interjection. An interjection is a word which expresses a strong feeling or emotion. Bravo, hooray, oh, hey, wow, ouch, etc. are interjections. Example, number one, ah, that feels wonderful. Number two, bless you, couldn't have done it without you. Bravo, he acted so courageously. Number four, hey, here he comes. Here the words, ah, bless you, bravo, hey, expresses some strong feeling or emotion, which could be a sorrowness, which could be a happiness, which could be a pettiness, etc. These were the 8 parts of speech. Hope you understood them. And with the help of these, you can place the word correctly in a sentence in a correct meaning and order. Thank you.